Montgomery, Pineedom Park, and Cos Cob is 102 acres of trails, ponds, and the leftover remnants of its past inhabitants. Old structures and ruins can be found throughout the park. But by far, the most impressive are these. This was Windigul, the home of Ernest Thompson Seton, famed explorer, naturalist, artist, and author. From 1901 to 1912, this was Seton's country manor house. He planted trees, and he built a dam to create this lake. He imported squirrels, otters, fox, peacocks, and even skunks. He created his own highly stylized naturalist paradise. But some of the local boys were not impressed with Windigul. They vandalized its front gates and fences. And after repairing the damage to his property several times, Ernest Thompson Seton took matters into his own hands. He didn't call the police. Instead, he marched down to the local school and invited the boys to a weekend stay on his property. Seton believed he could win these boys over. He was quoted as saying, "Not one boy in 1,000 is born bad. Boys have badness thrust upon them." The boys were a little suspicious at first, but Seton soon won them over with his stories of Indian lore and his lessons of the natural world. And so the boys returned, again and again. They camped and they canoed on the lake. They learned wilderness survival. Seton's outreach was a tremendous success. And from those 42 boys, Seton created a national organization, the League of Woodcraft Indians. In 1906, Seton met Lord Robert Baden-Powell. Baden-Powell was interested in starting his own youth group for boys in England. And from this meeting was born today's Boy Scouts of America. And these same Boy Scouts are here today. Windigul was sold in 1912, and Seton's naturalist manor eventually fell into disrepair. The town of Greenwich came to own the property. But the story of the Woodcraft Indians doesn't end there. In 2012, a local Boy Scout, Robbie Tillett, began his Eagle Scout project. He had taken on the task of clearing out an old trail here in the park. Tillett and Troop 9 cleared out wheelbarrows full of overgrowth, brush, and fallen trees. Under all those years of growth, they found a strange sculpture, a standing rock cemented into place on another rock. No one knew of any sculptures in this part of the park. After reviewing some old photographs, it was clear what the boys had found. This was the ceremonial stone that Ernest Thompson Seton had built for his original Woodcraft Indians over 100 years before. This picture taken in 1905 shows the boys dancing in front of what has come to be known as Medicine Rock. It's a great picture. The boys are unguarded and carefree, completely absorbed in the joy of their dance. Since then, about 110 million Americans have been involved in scouting. These boys could not have possibly known that they would be the first of generations of scouts to follow. Thanks for watching. To you when I die.